Hi guys, in this video I'll be discussing with you all the best strategy that you can follow to prepare power electronics subject. Okay, so in case of power electronics, this is basically asked in electrical engineering. Though there are some portions which are included in ECE, but in ESE examination, that is engineering services examination, in ECE also thyristors is asked, but in EE this is full fledgedly asked. So the weightage, when we talk about weightage, the weightage of this subject in GATE examination is between 8 to 10 marks. Okay, it is one of the core subjects of electrical engineering and hence it is very important. And then if we talk about the books for theory, you can follow the book by Rashid. For numericals, you can follow PS Bhimbra, and then you can also follow previous year. Previous year questions of GATE as well as ESE you can solve in order to gain a command over this subject. Now, what is the major difficulty when we talk about the major issue that is faced by everyone when studying power electronics is lot of formulas. Okay, the major problem that when you face lot of formulas, you are not able to retain it. The reason is that you are trying to cram up the formulas. Okay, if you are directly writing down all the formulas at a single place and trying to remember them, then it will be very difficult. So the solution is solve at least 5 to 10 problems on each concept. Second solution, remember only the formulas asked in last 5 years. Whatever formulas have been asked in last 5 years in GATE examination, you only have to remember them. You don't have to remember all the formulas. And if you go by this strategy, the number of formula that you are thinking are very high will get very much reduced. Okay, so try and follow this strategy so that you don't have to worry about retaining all the formulas. Now let us start unit by unit. So the first unit in power electronics is by the name power semiconductor devices. Okay, in power semiconductor devices, first of all you have to study about the basics. Basics is what is power electronics, why are we studying power electronics, what are the advantages of power electronics, what are the disadvantages. By studying this, you get to know why we are studying the power electronics, what is the physical significance, and then the other topic that is prerequisite for power electronics is Fourier series. Okay, if you know Fourier series well, then only you can judge the performance of converter. Then next you will talk about switches. Switches are of two categories, ideal switch and practical switch. So you have to understand the difference between the two, and then you will study about different switches like diodes, how diode behaves as a switch, like thyristor, like GTO, like triac, BJT, MOSFET. All these things you have to study, that is how these are behaving as a switch and what are their ideal characteristics. In this you have to study about the unipolar and bipolar type of switch. Okay, then the second thing that you have to study about is unidirectional and bidirectional switch. Okay. Then you also have to compute different power losses in the switch, like switching power loss, like conduction power loss. If you have derived all this, then you can understand the meaning of different devices working as switches. In this also you have to remember how you will connect two or more switches in series and parallel, and then how will the characteristics change. That is, how are the characteristics after connecting switches together. If you connect the switches together, how the characteristics change, that you have to study. Okay. After that, you will come to devices one by one. So the first device that you will study will be power diode. In power diode, you will study about the characteristics, the types like normal diode, Schottky diode, fast recovery diode. And then you will study about the reverse recovery phenomena. This reverse recovery is very important when we go about thyristor as well, because it dictates the turn off time of a device. Then you will come to the most important device, that is silicon controlled rectifier, SCR. Okay, that is the most important device. So what you have to study in this? Construction of the device and how does this device work. Then the significance of gate pulse, how gate pulse works, why is gate pulse applied. Third thing, latching current. Then you have to solve about problems about latching current, that is finding minimum pulse width. Okay, latching current defines the minimum pulse width, so you have to understand when latching current is given how you will find the minimum pulse width. Next thing that you have to study is holding current. In holding current there will be no numericals, you just have to understand the significance. Then you will study about characteristics of SCR. Characteristics, you have to study about two characteristics. First is anode characteristic, the second is gate characteristic. In gate characteristic, you also have to practice numericals. In numericals, what it will ask you is it will ask you whether or not SCR will be triggered, and basically it will ask you the gate voltage that is required to trigger the SCR, gate current it can ask you the power dissipation at the gate terminal. All these things can be asked based on anode characteristic. Numericals are not generally asked, and these sort of questions you will easily find in PS Bhimra. There are a lot of numericals based on gate characteristics. Then the next topic that you will study in SCR is triggering of SCR. There are various methods of triggering, like thermal triggering, like light triggering, like gate pulse triggering. And in this case, you will also study the concept of high frequency gate pulse and also the pulse transformer. Okay, that is how pulse transformer is used. So that will be about triggering of SCR. Then you will study about protection of SCR. There are various methods of protection, such as gate protection, such as series protection, such as over voltage protection, such as dv by dt protection. So it is against overcurrent, over voltage, dv by dt protection, di by dt protection, thermal protection, gate protection. Okay, This concept is important because it employs the concept of heat sink. So numerical can be asked here. Okay. Then dV by dt, there is snubber circuit. This concept is also important. Similarly, in di by dt also we have snubber circuit. Then the next topic that can be asked is connections of SCR. Though it is not very important for gate point of view, so here you have to study about series and parallel connection, and then you have to understand the values of resistance and capacitance required in series connection. Okay, it will ask you the values. So that is all that you have to study about the about the silicon controlled rectifier. If you want, you can also study about triggering circuit, though it is not required in gate. Okay, I am marking a cross against gate, that is, it is not required. Here you will study about the resistance circuit, RC circuit, UJT circuit. If you want, you can study, and if you want you can also leave it. Then the next thing that you will study is other devices. First of all, you have to study about thyristor family. In thyristor family, you will study about GTO. What is special about GTO? Asymmetrical SCR, reverse conducting thyristor, and triac. These are the devices about which you must have a knowledge in thyristor family. Then when you go about transistor family, what are the devices that you need to study about? Power BJT, power MOSFET, and then IGBT. So you have to study construction, working, and differences between these devices. Why any device is preferred over the other device and where each device will be used. So that you have to study. Here you don't need to solve any numericals. Okay, no numericals is required to understand this topic. The most important part of this entire chapter is your SCR. So you have to study SCR in detail. Other devices are not that much required. Then we will go to the second chapter, that is called as phase controlled converter. This is the widest chapter that you have to study under power electronics. Okay, it is also called as rectifier. Here in phase controlled converter, you will have to divide it into two categories: single phase and three phase. In single phase also, you can divide it into two categories: half wave and full wave. In half wave, actually, we have further two categories. It is called as uncontrolled, and the second one is fully controlled. But in full wave, we have three categories: uncontrolled, semi-controlled, fully controlled. Similarly, in three phase, we have half wave and full wave. In half wave again, we have two categories: uncontrolled, fully controlled. In full wave, we have three categories: uncontrolled, semi-controlled, and fully controlled. Okay, now in uncontrolled, it means we are only using diodes. Fully controlled means we are only using SCR. Here diodes, SCR, here diode as well as SCR. That is what it means. In half wave rectifier, you have to study about all the possible loads, like resistive load, inductive load, RL load, RL load, after that RE load, then RLE load. Okay, all these loads you have to study in case of half wave rectifier. In full wave rectifier, we will mostly study about RL load and R load. In RL load also, we will assume it to be highly inductive so that current is constant. In three phase half wave, we'll mostly work on R load and RL load. RL load will not be highly inductive, but in full wave we'll only focus on RL load, which is highly inductive. Though there are other possibilities as well, but these are the things that are generally asked in GATE exam. So practice as many problems on each converter as possible. And you have to remember the expression for average voltage, average current, and you don't need to remember for RMS. Remember the method to compute RMS. You have to understand how to compute the RMS value, but only in case of resistive load, because power dissipation is derived using RMS. Thirdly, you have to understand all the waveforms so that in case of emergency, in case of any non-trivial question, you can draw the waveforms and then you can derive the result. If you are good at drawing the waveforms, how can you become good at drawing the waveforms? When you are studying single phase half wave rectifier, there you have to understand how do the different type of loads affect the waveform. How can we draw waveform for different types of load? If you understand that well, then you won't have any problem while drawing any waveform. So waveforms are not directly important. Most of the questions are formula based. But sometime if you want to get a rank below 10 or 100, you need to be good at waveforms, because in that case, if some question is out of the box, it requires basic, then you will need to understand the waveform. Other than that, in this chapter, what you need is the effect of source inductance. Okay, that is how source inductance affects the average voltage. So we have to understand the effect on V naught average. That is how much the average voltage drop due to source inductance. In this case, you have to understand about single phase half wave, single phase full wave, and three phase full wave. These three cases you have to remember. How does the source inductance affect? So you have to remember two expressions. One is for V naught average, other is for I naught. So you remember these two expressions for these three converter, and you can solve any problem based on source inductance. Then the last topic that is not in GATE syllabus is dual converter. It is a very simple and very small topic, but it is only included in ESE. Okay, so if you are just preparing for GATE, you can remove this. Then the next one, the third chapter that you have to study is chopper. So first you have to understand the basic about chopper. What is a chopper and why chopper is used? Then you will study about step down chopper and its Fourier series. How are the harmonics induced due to chopper? Then there are three converters that you have to work on. First one is called as buck converter. The second one is called as boost converter. And the third one is called as buck boost converter. In these, what you have to do is, in buck converter, first of all, you have to work on exact analysis without any filter. That is, if we don't apply any filter, such as inductive filter, how will the analysis of converter be formed? Other than that, in all the three, first of all, you have to understand about volt second balance. This volt second balance is used to find the average output voltage. Then you will study about ampere second balance. This ampere second balance is used to find the average inductor current. Here L does not represent load, it is average inductor current. The third thing that you have to find out is ripple in inductor current. That is delta IL. Okay, these are along with filter that you are finding. Fourth one, ripple in V naught. Fifth one, you have to find the average thyristor or average switch current, average diode current. Okay, critical inductance, critical capacitance. Okay. If you remember how to find each of these parameters, it is very important, and the methods remain the same for all the three converter, buck converter, boost converter and buck boost converter, and you have to remember the circuits of each of three converters. Okay. Then basically in case of chopper, you also have to study about thyristor commutation. In commutation, there are four techniques: class A, class B, which is also called as current commutation. Okay. Class C, or it is called as complementary commutation. And the last one, class D, which is called as voltage commutation. Out of all these techniques, even we can call class A by load commutation. Okay. Only class D is most important. If you can understand the working of each of these commutation techniques, it is very good. If not, you can remember the maximum current through the main thyristor, ITM peak. Then you can remember the peak current through the auxiliary thyristor. You can remember the circuit turnoff time. If you remember these three parameters for all the converters, that will directly be asked. Otherwise, if you can understand how these circuits are working, it is very good. Then we also have the types of chopper based on quadrant. Types of choppers based on quadrant of operation, that also you can study, like type A. Okay, type B, type C, all these things. Type A chopper is actually step down chopper, or you can also call it as buck converter. So if you understand all these concepts, then chopper is fine, but try and understand the concepts behind deriving each of the quantity. In that case, you won't have to remember any expression in case of chopper. Then the next topic that we have to study is your inverter. Okay, inverter is a relatively smaller topic. So where it will start is, it will start with single phase inverter. In single phase inverter, you have to study two types of inverter, half bridge and full bridge. Here what you will understand in both these is, first of all, Fourier series of output voltage. Then second is the waveform for different type of load, like inductive load, RL load, resistive load, RLC underdamped, RLC overdamped. All these things you have to understand how to draw the waveform, and then find the time of conduction of diode, time of conduction of switch, peak current. That is only for purely inductive load, it will ask you the peak current. All these things you have to study in single phase inverter. Then you will move on to three phase inverter. In three-phase inverter, you have two cases, 120 degree conduction mode and 180 degree conduction mode. In both these cases, you have to understand the waveforms of phase and line voltage. Then what are the formulas that you have to remember? The RMS value of phase voltage, RMS value of line voltage, okay? Then RMS value of fundamental phase voltage, RMS value of fundamental line voltage. Then RMS current in each phase, RMS current through each device. These formulae you have to understand, and if you can remember these expressions, then you don't need any waveform in case of three-phase inverter. Then you will study a bit about current source inverter. Only how does it work? Then auto sequential commutated inverter. That is also a category of CSI, but it is auto commutated. After that, you will come to the most important concept, that is your pulse width modulation. In pulse width modulation, you will understand what is pulse width modulation and why is it required. Then you will start with the first one, SPM, single pulse modulation. This is the most important as per previous years. Here what you have to understand is the waveform, then RMS output, then Fourier series of the waveform. Then the next one is multiple pulse modulation. It is not very important from gate point of view. Then the last one, sinusoidal pulse width modulation. Okay, in this you have to understand about the fundamental peak voltage, which is modulation index into VDC. MA is the modulation index, which is V reference upon V carrier. Okay, so these pulse width modulation technique, this is the most modern type of technique or the latest technique that has been included in the GATE syllabus, and as per the recent trend, it is most important. Okay, earlier the most important was single pulse modulation, now most important is sinusoidal pulse width modulation. So do prepare these two things very well. So this is all about GATE course. Other than that, you can also prepare AC voltage controller. It was earlier used to be in GATE, but now it has been removed. Here you will understand about AC voltage regulator, half wave and full wave, then on off control of AC voltage regulator. Then you can also study about cyclo converter. But remember, this AC voltage controller is not in GATE. Also, you can study about AC and DC drives, in which DC drive is more important for ESE. This whole topic is again not in GATE. It earlier used to be, then it has been removed. So here what you have to study about, how you will use rectifiers, choppers, inverters, all these things along with your electrical machine such as DC motor, induction motor, that you have to study. Okay, if you are preparing for ESE, then you can prepare these two topics also, but in GATE course only up to inverters is included. Okay, so if you prepare this topic well, then you won't have to remember very much formulae. But if you only go by formulae, then there is no end. Always remember, only those formulas you have to memorize which have been asked in the past 5 years, and then you see the number of formula that you are worrying about are very less, and you can regularly revise it in order to keep them fresh. Okay, power electronics is a subject which requires regular revision. Is it fine? Thank you.